Catholic Answers Live, now saying hi to Brendan in Massachusetts on Sirius 130. Hello, Brendan.
Hey, how you doing? Thanks for taking my call.
Right on. Welcome aboard.
I'm calling about a documentary, which I'm pretty sure you're aware of, the Star of Bethlehem documentary.
Yes, I'm aware of it.
Yeah, okay, and I know you're somewhat of a star expert from reading your blog.
So well, one, I wouldn't say that, but thank you.
He's more of a star witness.
My thing is, one, I was very impressed by it. Mm-hmm. I don't want to be sold a bill of goods.
Right.
I don't know where to go to check, you know, the veracity of anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you commented once on it that you generally liked it, but there was maybe a couple things, and I was hoping you'd comment on it. I'd give you a little bit of...
Brendan, what's your question? How does it sound as a question, Brendan? Fire away.
How accurate is the documentary, one? Two, if it is accurate, what does that mean for astrology in the future?
Okay.
The stars.
Okay.
All right. So the documentary Bethlehem Star. What is it, Jimmy?
It's a documentary that was made a few years ago about the Star of Bethlehem, and what it does is it looks into it uses, you know how they have astronomy programs these days that run on computers where you can run the sky forward and backwards over thousands of years mm-hmm. and look at different astronomical phenomena. And what this documentary tries to do is identify some plausible astronomical phenomena that occurred during the relevant time frame of when Jesus was born that could have been the Bethlehem Star.
Like a supernova or a sudden comet.
Yeah, although, I mean, it talks about things like that, but the candidates it ends up identifying tend to be conjunctions. Of different planetary and celestial bodies.
Conjunction, not a term from Sesame Street or grammar.
No, when two different objects in the sky come into close proximity, they're said to be in conjunction.
Creating a bright, quote-unquote, star.
Yeah, they may even appear as one brighter body, depending on how close the conjunction is. So it proposes some conjunctions, and it gives reasons why these conjunctions could have been seen by the Magi as signs that a king was born in Israel, and there's plausibility to that, and I think that the filmmaker has correctly identified the right time frame for Jesus's birth. There's some discussion of which range of years he was born in, but I think that the filmmaker has the right range of years, and I think he has some plausible candidates, and they even occur on some interesting dates, like December 25th, for example. But but there are, in a while back when I was watching it with a critical eye to say, okay, are there ways I can poke holes in this? There were. One of the things that I was not confident of, and I'd like to do some more research on, is the degree to which the film corrects for geographical location. Because what you're going to see if you're in Baghdad, let's say, a plausible place for where the Magi might have come from, you know, somewhere in Mesopotamia.
Works for me.
Is not what you're going to see in the sky at that same moment in Judea, in Jerusalem. And so you have to not only correct for various factors related to the day and the year, you also have to correct for
Earth curvature.
For Earth curvature and location, for longitude and latitude. And I'm not sure that the filmmaker has done enough work in that area. So I think there's promising stuff in the Bethlehem Star, and it's also been explored elsewhere. It's not unique to this guy. If you want to read some similar stuff on that, there's a book called The Handbook of Biblical Chronology by Jack Finnegan, which is out of print right now. There are out of print copies you can get. It's also going to be coming back into print later this year. It's an awesome book on biblical chronology, frankly the best. Mm. And it also covers some of this astronomical stuff connected with the star. So I recommend that for further follow-up. I hope to blog about this more someday as I've been able to research it further, but I haven't gotten there yet.
What about people who use this as a fulcrum to accept astrology?
Oh, good, the astrology question. Mm. Well, we can't deny that God sometimes gives signs through nature. I mean, either in the sky or through other means, I mean, the burning bush and so forth. Mm-hmm. The problem is that miraculous things and prophetic things of this nature, we don't have a lot of information about. So it would be entirely speculative to try to find a new series of signs in the sky. God just hasn't revealed to us. I mean, he may have revealed, let's say, to the prophet Daniel, who then passed it on to the Chaldeans. When you see this kind of sign, it means the Messiah is born.
Right.
But we don't have that kind of information today. And so it's very dangerous. And so in his book on the infancy narratives, Pope Benedict says that astrology, whatever role it had in the ancient world, finds its end in the Star of Bethlehem.
Interesting. So you can't prescind from that and go to, when I was born, this configuration
exactly.
of the zodiac means X about me, which always struck me as kind of dumb, given how arbitrary one's birth date is.
And how arbitrary such interpretations are.
Amen. Brendan, how does that sound,
thanks,
sir?
Thanks a lot. I really appreciate it. Help me a ton.
All right.
Awesome.
Thank you very much.